overhead, the glider army headed toward its objective as the boats went in. From the air, ships could be seen stretching for miles in the choppy water along the coast. Back and forth across the channel, the air traffic continued without halt. Rocket ships added their weight to the destruction of the beach defenses. The landing craft made their drive toward shore through lanes cleared during the night by minesweepers. Until the last possible moment, our planes hit at the enemy on the shoreline. Landing craft of all descriptions negotiated the last dangerous stretch of water. The Air Forces did not neglect targets inland. Everything that could hinder our advance was subject to attack from the sky. The moment when Allied soldiers were going to put foot on French soil was close at hand. To make the foot soldiers' job easier, our planes struck at roads and transport leading up toward the threatened coast. From the ships, field artillery pieces joined battle while waiting to disembark. The men in the landing craft tensed for the impact of the moment when they hit the beach. our fighters made sure that the Luftwaffe stayed on the ground. A few hundred feet ahead lay France. Sea-going tanks were brought up quickly to meet German armor. More men stepped onto the continent, into the fire of enemy guns that had survived the preliminary bombardment.